the second half, he had 19 points in the second half. But RJ said every time he looked into the paint that Armando had a guy sealed.
He did.
How was he able to get all the different defenses that they were throwing, defenders they were throwing at him, get them all sealed, and to the point where he had an open into the basket each time he got his touch?
He outworked them. I mean, it is what it is. You can call whatever play. You can design whatever half-court set. If the player is not going to work hard to catch the ball where we want them to catch it in order to be able to do something, it's just a waste of time. And so, you know, one of the things that Armando did really well is in transition, his ability just to seal his man right in the middle of the paint. It's a perfect place to get him the ball because they can't double-team him. It's in transition, and he just did a really good job of getting good low position sealing. It was a really nice job by our players to get him the ball when he was open near the basket. And so we felt like it was an advantage for us to dominate points in the paint. It was an emphasis. It's been an emphasis every day since the beginning of the year. But, you know, we talked about getting back to that, you know, because over the last, you know, four or five games, you know, we were shooting more threes than we were getting to the free throw line. And so that was a huge emphasis for us, and Armando was fantastic offensively.
Hubert, you guys have been playing two times a week for basically the last month and a half, two months.
2 years.
Yeah. Now you have a seven-day break before going to Virginia next Saturday. Does it feel kind of weird to have that?
No, it feels good. It feels good. I think it's a great time for us to have a week off to catch our breath. I think it's a great week for us to physically just have a rest. But I think it's also, and this is the most important thing, it's a week of practice where we can practice, not necessarily prepare. And I think the games, you know, our schedule, we've been practicing, but we've been practicing preparing for a game. Obviously, we need to do that for Virginia next week, but at the beginning of next week, we can actually have a practice. And we can work on things that we need to improve on both ends of the floor and just sharpen the discipline and details that allow, you know, those little things that allow us to experience big things. So that this week is really big for us.
On that note, is it kind of a break in the schedule, given how different the pack line can be, to have those extra practices leading up to Virginia?
Well, no, not necessarily. I just think it comes at a really good time. You know, it just... As I said before, you know, it's hard. You know, you have to find the joy in how hard it is to be successful individually and as a team. And, you know, the middle of the late February, it's a long season. And it's nice to have this semi-break to be able to rest physically, mentally, but also work on us as opposed to working on us in preparation to play this particular team. And I think... For us, I think that's really good. And I feel like that's really good in preparation to play a really good Virginia team.
You guys were able to dictate the way this game was played? And if so, why?
I wouldn't use those words. I just, you know, from an offensive standpoint, we knew we wanted to dominate points in the paint. And so whether through post penetration or offensive rebounding, I mean, we got 14 offensive rebounds. If we didn't get the rebound, I felt like we did a nice job of keeping the ball alive. We shot more free throws than we did three-pointers, so that's something that we talked about and we did really well. You know, and defensively, I thought the first half we did well. The second half, you know, percentage-wise, it was fine. I just, you know, there were times where because of Couture and their other guards really good coming off screens, I felt like they were able to get into the paint and, you know, we put them on the free throw line for 20 free throws. So those are things that we can clean up. But overall, I felt really good about our performance today.
Adams next. Before, the 54 points in the paint are the second most all year. The only time more was the big one here over Syracuse.
Hubert, with Harrison, his knack for offensive rebounding, we've talked about it all season, but maybe the appetite there, like who does he remind you of in terms of just his offensive rebounding? Is there anybody that comes to your mind?
Armando? I mean, he doesn't do anything special. What he does, he goes every time. I mean, there's no technique. I mean, rebounding is will, want to, desire, toughness. And every time the ball goes up, yes, you can look at the shot and you can anticipate where, if it's a miss, where it would go. But it's all about pursuit and willingness to go get the ball. He goes every time. Every time there's a shot goes up, he goes. And so he puts himself in a position, even tip outs, loose balls, the ball. I really believe this. The ball finds effort.
Sure. Yeah.
It just does. And he goes to the offensive glass every time, and it's not surprising that the ball ends up in his hands.
How do you feel about getting the lead and finishing up the whole game, closing out the whole game?
It was good. You know, I think I saw some stat when I was watching one of our games, and just in review, that was it 6 of the 7 or 7 of the 8 games we were either tied or down at half. And, you know, it was really important for us to get off to a good start. You know, and then one of the things that I thought that I was really proud of them was we ended the first half on, it was a 5-point game. We ended up 6-0, and then we went into half at 11 points. And then I thought we started off the second half really well. And so those are things that we can, you know, continue and things that we need to moving forward.
Hubert, how, I guess, important has it been getting Seth back? I know he did play, obviously, against Syracuse. He had like 21 minutes today. How big has it been, you know, getting him back in the lineup? It seemed like he was a little bit more comfortable.
Yeah, I mean, it just doesn't work without him. You know, he's just his defense on the ball, his athleticism on the defensive end to help us rebound. You know, you could put him on any guard, whether he likes to come off screens or you saw him pick up, you know, 94 feet. And so he's really disruptive there. On the offensive end, he's shooting the ball much better this year. But his ability to attack the basket, I just think he can get to the basket, get to the paint anytime he wants to. And I thought his passing was really good. A lot of times, you know, on the skip passes or out of the double team, we always talked about good to great. And he did a really – he should get, you know, I don't know how many assists he had. Like, he had four – he had hockey assists. You know, he had like 4 or 5 hockey assists. And so, like, just his energy and effort and his ability, you know, we just needed out there, and he was really good today.
He's claiming 6 and has asked for a review, so.
He's claiming 6?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. Field repeat.
Okay. Interesting.
Four is a season high.
Yeah. When I asked you yesterday about Cormac, I get everything that you were saying about the whole of his game. It's not just shooting, but
it's nice.
Yeah, but he's 10 for 21 the last 3 games from 3.
Yeah.
What does it do when he's suddenly in that consistent realm?
I agree with you, and it does. You know, in combination with Harrison and RJ, now you've got 3 guys that are shooting the ball at a high level. And what that does is that gives us even more space. It gives space to Armando.
I was going to ask if that was a byproduct of that.
Yes. It gives space to Armando. It gives space to our guards. Elliot being able to get into the gaps. It gives us spacing. You know, everyone, you know, from an offensive standpoint, they talk about spacing. Yeah, you can put, you know, corner, you know, spread everybody out. But if they can't shoot, people are still going to be in the lane. You got to have guys that can shoot. And so with Cormac being more in rhythm from 3 now, that adds another, you know, in combination with his reputation, an elite shooter, and it just opens up our offense even more.
Couple more.
Hubert, with RJ, like, I don't know, has patience maybe become one of the overlooked qualities with him? I think he only had 2 shots the first 15 minutes of the game. He still ends up with 20 points. You know, like, is that?
That's a good player.
Sure.
That I'm telling you, that's just a good player. When you look at, you know, 13 shots and 20 points off of 13 shots, that's a good player. You know, and 5 assists, I mean, I just gets to the free throw line, defends, that's a good player. And you're right, you know, he had limited points, you know, starting the game, and his patience of understanding that, you know, he's going to get his looks. And I'm just also understanding that, you know, we wanted to feature Armando and just dominate points in the paint. Us being able to do that opens him up out there on the perimeter. And so he has my vote for ACC Player of the Year. I don't have a vote, but.
Noted. Some of us do.
Hubert,
then
vote. That way.
I'm sure you saw, but your uncle was named a finalist for the Naismith Hall of Fame this week. What does it mean to you to see him get that honor?
Well, got this. He should be in the Hall of Fame. 16 years in the NBA, 7-time All-Star, Rookie of the Year in 78. All-American here. He should be in the Hall of Fame. It's about time. And that's my uncle.
That's his vote.
That's my vote. Anybody have a vote? Didn't vote. I know. Let's do this.
Everybody good?
I like it.
What is the schedule for this week? Tomorrow, how are you kind of laying
out? Tomorrow, we have a Special Olympics event tomorrow. And then Monday, we'll have have run and shoot on Monday, and then practice on Tuesday. We'll do some film work and some light stuff on Wednesday, and then Thursday and Friday, get ready to go.
All right, thanks everybody.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.